Hello children, this is Seema Singh again with the same lesson, the Song of Songs. Okay, in my yesterday's video, I told you that Tansen and Akbar went to meet Sant Haridas. Haridas was Tansen's guru and Tansen told Haridas to sing. But Haridas said he has passed the age of singing. Now he's become very old, so he cannot sing. And Tansen, to make Haridas sing, he said he will sing for Sant Haridas. He will sing for his guru. And he started singing. But while singing, he was deliberately making the mistake so that Sant Haridas would take the Tanpura, and in the pretext of correcting him, he will start singing. So, let's see further. However, Tansen knew how to get around him. He offered to sing before his guru and then he sang. He made a deliberate mistake. "That's not the right note, Tansen," cried the teacher amazed. "What has happened to you?" Okay, and Tansen started singing. But while singing, he deliberately made mistake. Yesterday also I told you deliberately means janbujhkar wo wrong aa raha tha. Ki Haridas wo usse tanpura leke and he will start singing. Tansen pretended not to understand his teacher and made the same mistake again. Exasperated, Sant Haridas took the Tanpura from Tansen's hand and sang the right note. Then he went to the next and next. Okay. Even when Haridas corrected Tansen, Tansen did the same mistake deliberately in the pretext that Haridas will take Tanpura from him and he will start singing. Same thing happened when Tansen was not singing properly, not singing correctly. Haridas took Tanpura from Tansen and started singing. First he sang one note, then he sang next and he continued singing. The melody of his voice spread across the forest like a first glimmer of the dawn or the fragrance of jasmine. Both Akbar and Tansen listened to him as if he hypnotized. Akbar realized that Tansen had spoken the truth. He had not known that music could be so heavenly. He had certainly not heard anything like it before. Okay, when Sant Haridas started singing, Akbar and Tansen both lost in the music. It was appearing as if they can smell the fragrance of jasmine. The first sun rays was coming, of the dawn was appearing, and it was feeling to Tansen and Akbar as if they have been hypnotized. So Akbar and Tansen were deeply lost in the music as if they were hypnotized. And Akbar, then he realized, yes, whatever Tansen was saying, that is true. Haridas sang much, much better than Tansen. He thought that he had never thought that music could be so heavenly. Heavenly means bilkul aisa lag raha tha jaise wo log swarg mein aa gaye the. Okay, and before this he had never heard such a beautiful and a sweet voice. Okay, now then the last paragraph I'm reading, children. As they walked back, Emperor suddenly broke the silence to ask Tansen, "Why can't you sing like him, Ustadji?" Tansen smiled. "Shehenshah, I sing at your command, the command of the Emperor of Hindustan. Guru just sings for the one who is king of kings. His music springs from depth of his soul, free and unanswered for. How can my music hope to reach to those heights?" Okay, after listening to Haridas, when the concert was over, Akbar and Tansen started going back to the palace. And after enjoying the music to the fullest, Akbar suddenly broke his silence. He asked Tansen, "Ustadji, why you can't sing like your guru Haridas?" Then Tansen answered, "Shehenshah, I sing for you. Whereas my guru, I sing for you at your command. Whatever you want to sing, I sing for you. Whatever you say, I sing that. But my guru, Sant Haridas, sings for nobody. He sings only for God, who is the king of kings." Means Bhagwan se bada koi nahi, aur mere guru ji jo hai wo sirf Bhagwan ke liye gana gaate hain, aur kisko inko command nahi karta. Nobody orders him, nobody tells him. He is free to sing whatever he wants. He sings from his soul. He sings from the depth of his soul. So as I sing for you as at your command, how can my voice reach to that height? Okay, children, this is all in the chapter.